Nebulous here. I'm gonna be doing a Team Fortress 2 gameplay. Basic spy gameplay. I'm gonna be narrating it. And we're gonna see how good of a game we do. First things first, we're gonna want to disguise as our own team since we're using the Dead Ringer. This will allow us to safely observe the outside while not being seen as suspicious. Unlike this spy who's chosen to disguise as Red right away. And we're gonna take a look at the exit to see what we gotta deal with. This exit looks like our safest retreat, far away from the enemy. So when we go to leave, we're gonna make sure this Dead Ringer's popped out. Because if we get shot without it, we will die. Now the traditional spy watch would also work, but that requires a few different maneuvers. Alright. Gate's down, we're gonna get shot at right away. That's down. We're gonna go 3. Tuck in here real quick. No one saw the decloak. These sentries are gonna be a real problem, so let's try and take them out. So we're gonna wanna make sure our sapper's up. And let's see. Oh, he abandoned them. He popped the one on his dispenser, but oh, he shot me, but he doesn't suspect me anymore. We just real quick, he's gonna shoot us. We're gonna go 6, go as an engineer, decloak back here. We got a nice large med pack all to ourselves. We're gonna wait for the cloak to come back, but it looks like we did our job. Yep, 3 confirmed destructions. Pretty good. Our team is pushing up. They're gonna come to the second point. Oh, let's try and get this soldier. Let's see, can we get the soldier? Yes, we got the soldier. Nice. And you know what? Let's go Demo Man. Again, wait for our flinger, our Dead Ringer. I'm just gonna call it the Dead Ringer 2. There we go. We got the second point. Oh, med ammo there. Okay, they're gonna start setting up defenses, so let's try and get these. Oh! Oh, nope, nope, could not get a stab on that. I gotta fall back. Okay. Real low on health, I'm surprised they even made it out of that. And more health. We're gonna try and hang back here as Red for a while. If we're lucky, we weren't too badly seen. I'm sorry if the audio's a bit weird. My audio's not quite set up that well. And here we are back out. Okay, they got their defenses. Let's try and see if we could get a tag on that heavy. One of these heavies. These heavies will cause us a lot of trouble. Oh, got a lot of sentries here. Let's try and jump over. Dang it. That didn't work. Let's just... Oh, got a nice stab on that one. Holy crap. Oh. We're not gonna make it past this, so let's just. Oh, that's nice. It's real nice. It starts shooting him. Okay, now we already used that one. Let's go sniper so we can hang back a while. Oh, there's that sentry. Let's see if we can snipe him. Got him! Nice! Again, I'm gonna go sniper. Our flinger is back up. Our Dead Ringer, I'm just gonna call it the Dead Ringer. Let's back up, let's try and... Ooh, there's another sniper, let's get him. Oh, dang it, he turned around just right. Damn it. Oh, he got that turnaround just the right moment. Okay, let's go in as a medic this time. Alright, we're just the medic leaving spawn. We see our sniper buddy, he needs some help. There's my old body. Let's just wait for this Dead Ringer to recharge. And got it! Is he gonna chase? The engineer did not chase. Okay. We're back. Disguise is a nice NG. Let's try and see if we can. Got him. Oh, dang it, the sentry got us. Okay. 1 death, 5 kills, 5 destruction. Pretty good. Pretty good game. Then again, these are bots, so not the most intelligent creatures in the world. Alright, back in the game. Got our basic pistol. The default pistol is really the best pistol. You can try and use the other pistols. Personally, for me, the default, it may not seem that special, but the default is incredibly reliable for almost every situation. It's got just the right amount of damage, just the right amount of recoil. It's a really reliable gun. So let's try and... Oh, they got us, so we're gonna have to change disguise. We're gonna go... Oh, perfect. Ammo pack, right down here. Alright, that card's not moving, so we gotta try and break the red defenses as much as possible. Can we go through this window? No, we cannot go through that window. Ooh. There's another spy, which is gonna be pretty dangerous, because we can bump into him on accident. Oh! I did it again. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 please. Oh, sweet, I got his dispenser. Okay, so we got his dispenser. We had an engineer running up here, so try and kill him. He's a bit ditzy. I don't think we can reach him. That medic. Oh, no, the medic died. Damn it! Crap! That stupid stab again. Honestly, I really hate how quickly sentries kill you. It's unfair. Like, honest to God, please, someone nerf the goddamn sentry. I am so sick and tired of those things. You get one stab, you gotta stab it on the engineer, and they literally get one shell right in your chest, and you're dead. Okay, we're gonna go engineer. This medic's healing us. I really hate it when medics heal you. Please don't. If I'm going spy, do not touch me at all. Because that just raises a lot of red flags for the enemy team when they see an enemy medic healing their teammate. In fact, I wish that the disguise kit, when you're disguised as an enemy, didn't allow that, because there's a huge... Let's try and get this medic. This medic's a big threat. Damn it! This is a long run, long run, long run, long run! Barely made it out. Oh my gosh. Got that guy. Got that spy. He ran right back into me. He was probably chasing me, actually, now that I think about it. Try and get that dispenser. No, that's not gonna work. We're gonna have to go good old-fashioned disguise. I don't know why he kept checking me. I clearly was not dying, but apparently bots know how many hits it takes to kill someone. Alright, got another sniper up here. Well, let's see if we can go stab it on him. Got him. Pop that. 7%. Okay. We're gonna take a break from the stabbing and try and get ourselves health packs. Because the Dead Ringer can only save you for so long. Sooner or later, you're gonna hit that no return route. No health packs down there. Maybe we can get a little bit off this sentry if we're lucky. Yeah, that actually seems to work. Okay. Oop. Dang it! Come on! One more shot! Seriously! Okay, you know what? Let's try and break this front line. We're gonna go... Sniper. We're gonna go sniper, trying to break the front line for them, because sometimes you can't always play spy. That's something you gotta realize. You can't hold your class for an entire match. In fact, there's an achievement given to people that change their classes multiple times per match. And that means you're the real team player. I mean, no one likes the guy that just stays spy the whole round, even though the whole team clearly could use a medic. So there's a little TF2 tip. Always change classes regularly depending on who you need. Let's see. Oh, got the heavy. Alright, demo man. Let's see if we can probably tag that enemy sniper. Oh, he's a nice little perch. Get that medic. gun down the demo man. Doesn't go over too well, but we got him nice and weak. That heavy smile, though. That's a genuine smile right there. We did pretty good. We got 2 kills. We killed the demo man. We killed a heavy, a medic, and we got some shots in on the demo man. Which I say is pretty good. I say that's pretty good. I don't know about other snipers, but personally, I think the machine gun should be used way, the SMG should be used way more often. It's quite useful. Look at that, whole sentry down in one shot. Oh, enemy sniper over there. Oh, got us. Ah, we failed. Oh well. Well, you can't have all the victories. So next round, we're going red team. For red team, I'm also going to go spy, because I want to see... I don't usually play defensive spy, but let's see how this goes. So we're going to go defensive spy. Skin on our gun change. I like how it changes with the team. And of course, again, regular TF2 rules. Change your disguise to a red team member, or the color of your team. That way, you're not suspected as being a spy, because once people know there's a spy on the battlefield, they're guaranteed to start checking for spies when they leave. So I try and make it as clear as possible there are no spies around. That is, unless some... try and make myself as unsuspecting as possible. Because once they start thinking there's a spy nearby, they're gonna start looking for spies. Which is why stabs need to be taken very carefully, especially stabs and sapping. You need to be very careful with those, because those can often expose your position as a spy. Very quickly. You actually have a butterfly knife, they're pretty good. Alright, we're gonna want to hold out our dead right now. And you know what, while we're over here, we're gonna quickly go blue. Seeing how the gates are now open and blue soldiers and other team members are now running out into the field. Oh. Ooh. Dang, that was a close one. Okay. Didn't get that stab. He died right before we could actually get it. Nevertheless, looks like there's a heavy... No, our team's holding that cart pretty well. Oh, this scout. Nah, the sentry's gonna get him. Okay. This sniper... Come on, come on, come on! Nope, we had to pull it. Dang, that's not gonna work. Okay. Sniper's not really... Spy's not really fun on this, so we're gonna go soldier, actually, for the remainder of this match. Here's this... bot spy. He's not doing too good. He clearly has no idea what he's doing. He's clearly a noob. Unlike yours, truly. Mega Lightning Gaming, we are not noobs. We promise. We promise. Ooh, fantastic kills. What? I didn't even see one come through me. I didn't even see one show up. I swear, I did not even see one show up. Alright, I'm back in the game. You know, I got this TF2 skin for like 13 cents. And personally, I enjoy like quite a few skins on my guns, so... I don't know, I don't get those people that only save up for the valuable skins. Because, for me, I don't know, as long as it looks cool, I'm okay with it, I don't care about the value. This is only 13 cents skin. I think it looks awesome. Here's another pro tip. Never wear a gibbous. Just never wear a gibbous. Having no cosmetics definitely looks a lot better on you than having a gibbous. I know that sounds weird, but... when people see a gibbous, they immediately think that you're a bad player, and that's not good. because I'm sure there's plenty of good players that wear the Gimbus. But because it... Oh, no. You're not getting... Yaha! Yes. Oh, scout. Got him. Another scout. Oh my gosh, a whole platoon. Oh, that's our spy. Nice. Teamwork. Oh, where did he come from? These sneaky scouts. Like, so far these scouts have had more stealth than spies. This engineer has made the wise decision of pointing his gun at himself. Truly a genius of our time. That's the other thing. Although your gun can rotate at 360 degrees, I strongly suggest Vivo Engineer point your gun at the place where you want the bullets to initially go, because the gun takes a lot longer to turn 360 than you might think. Well, let's try Pyro for the rest of this round. I know I said that about the soldier, but let's just try, because we still have 5 minutes to actually stop the cart. Actually, no. You know what? Let's actually go medic, because that's actually what I'm good at. I actually know how to play medic. Playing medic, always jump around. It's kind of like what you always need to do, because you're most targeted by spies and other enemies. That's a spy. That one's a spy. Got him. The fact that just the fact that he ran away from me trying to heal him, though. Regular TF2 spies, actual players, will not do that, and they will try and get you to heal them. Bots are afraid of your metagun, especially enemy bots. So, if you ever see a bot refuse a heal, that most likely means they are indeed a spy. But yeah, something you need to always look out for is... Oh, there's a spy. Not doing too good at his job. That was the same spy, wasn't it? That's why I got a domination on him. Alright, I'm holding on to an Uber. I gotta make sure I don't die, because this Uber could change the tides in a matter of seconds. Let's fuck it this heavy. Just keep a strong eye on him. Let's see. Nothing big yet. Just pop it now so you can fight off that soldier safely. Let's actually send it over to this medic real quick. Just keep him alive. Oh, two spies! Oh boy, this got scary. This got creepy fast. There's the spy, he's running up. Got him. Yeah. Always try and use your needler as much as possible. I know medics sometimes try and stay more away from combat, but you were given the needler for a reason. You might as well use it. At least it's not as wimpy as one of those mercy pistols. I mean, honestly, guys, just give her a damn rifle. So, we're doing pretty good. I've been able to keep this group alive for quite a while. I don't think any of them died yet, especially this heavy. I don't think he's died. Died yet. I'm sure he will die sooner or later. Let's get this down there. Oh, that's a spy. Yep, I bumped him and everything. Okay. Oh, another spy. I didn't even get a single shot at him. Though the bots do it often, if you're ever playing medic, never stay still. And that actually goes for quite a few classes. Except for maybe the sniper, even he has slight movement time. But yeah, basically try and keep moving as much as possible. I think I already said that previously in the video. But just a little rehab. Is that a spy? Yep, that's a spy. Try and work an Uber chain. Let's keep this guy alive. He's Ubered, but his health is pretty low. Oh. Gotta get that guy. And him. Engineer. Oh, that engineer's fine. Nothing to get him. 10 seconds. It's all I need to hold this. 10 seconds, the episode's over. Okay, we got a few are you kidding me? I died in the overtime.
Victory.
Well, we won. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. And tune in next time when I do something else in TF2. Go ahead and suggest what class I should try and play all the way through next.